वेलकम टू श्रीमती एल पी सवानी विद्या भवन. माई सेल्फ भूमि पटनायक. टुडे आई टीच यू लेसन नंबर 2, GUI ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड इंट्रोडक्शन.
GUI ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम एंड इंट्रोडक्शन. ग्राफिकल यूजर इंटरफेस. अ ग्राफिकल यूजर इंटरफेस इज अ टाइप ऑफ यूजर इंटरफेस दैट अलाउज यूजर टू इंटरैक्ट विद इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस through graphical icons and visual indicators. GUI uses pictures to represent the input and output of a program. The program displays icon, buttons, dialog boxes, etc. on the screen. The user gives commands by selecting and clicking on icons displayed on the screen. Windows 7 is an example of a GUI. The main screen is called the desktop. It has small pictures on it called icons. Desktop icons represent different programs, files or folders. These can be opened by double-clicking the particular icon. Switching on the computer. You can work on the computer only when it is switched on. So it is very important to know how to switch on or start your computer. Let us see how to switch on a computer. Switch on the main power supply button. Switch on the power button on the UPS. Switch on the power button on the CPU box. Switch on the power button on the monitor. The computer takes some time before you see a screen on the monitor. This is because the computer first needs to load the operating system to start working. Operating system. A computer has a special set of programs which manages all the jobs of a computer and makes it run. This is known as operating system. An operating system helps a user to give an input to the computer and to get an output from the computer. A computer cannot function without an operating system. When you switch on a computer, the Windows operating system gets loaded into the computer memory automatically. The process is called booting. While booting, the picture of the Windows logo appears on the screen. A few seconds later, a welcome message appears, and a few seconds later, screen appears, which is known as desktop. After the system finishes booting, it becomes ready for you to work on desktop. When the process of booting is completed, the first screen that appears with small pictures on it is called the desktop, and the small pictures are called icons. The Windows desktop has different parts. Let's discuss them one by one. Icons. The desktop contains small pictures with names as recycle bin, network, computer, and many more. These all are called icons. Desktop icons represent different programs, files or folders. These can be opened by double-clicking the particular icon. A computer program is a collection of instructions. Each computer program performs a specific task. All the work that we do on a computer gets stored in the form of a file. A file is a collection of data, information, setting or commands. Files are of many kinds, like data files, program files and so on. Data files like sound files, movie files, document files, etc. Each file is given a unique name. This is known as the file name. Files may be stored together in a folder. A folder is a location for organizing and storing files. Each folder can be assigned a unique name. A folder may contain programs, files, and also other folders. Selecting and deselecting icon.
Selecting the icon. To select an icon, simply click on it. It will be highlighted. Deselecting the icon. To deselect an icon, click away from it. The icon will now be displayed in its original form. Selecting adjacent icons. Left click the first item to be selected, then hold down the shift key and click the last item to be selected. Release the shift key. All the adjacent items are selected. Selecting non-adjacent icons. Hold down the control key, click once on each of the items to be selected. In this manner, you can select the non-adjacent items.
Arranging the desktop icons. As you arrange your study desk, similarly, you can arrange the icons on the desktop to give it a better look. To arrange icons automatically on your desktop, follow the given steps.
Right-click on the blank area of desktop. You will find the list of options. Select the view option. Click the auto arrange icons option from the sub menu.
Sorting the icons. Sorting the desktop icons means arranging them in a proper sequence. To sort the icons, follow the given steps.
Right click on the blank area of desktop. You will find the list of options. A shortcut menu appears. Point to the sort by option and click the name sub option. The icons will be arranged in an alphabetical order.
Hide desktop icons. You can hide all the icons on the desktop. To hide the icons, follow the given steps. Taskbar. Taskbar is a long horizontal bar at the bottom of desktop. The taskbar has a system tray, quick launch bar, and start button. It also shows icon for the currently open programs. Start button, quick launch bar, open program, system tray. This is the notification area on the right of the taskbar, which includes a clock, date or time, and icons that show the status of certain programs and computer settings. Quick launch bar. This shows you which programs and files you have opened on the computer. It allows you to quickly switch between them. Start button. Start button. You will see the start button at the left corner of the computer screen. The start button can be used to find and open any program, file, or folder on your computer. When you left click on the start button, a menu appears on the screen. This is called the start menu. The start menu is divided into two panes, the left pane and the right pane. Right pane, left pane, start button. Left pane of the start menu. The left pane of the start menu shows a list of recently opened programs. Some of the programs have an arrow symbol placed next to their names. Moving the mouse pointer to any of these arrows displays the recently opened files in that program. The All Programs option is used to display the complete list of programs present in the computer. When you click All Programs, the program names are shown in alphabetical order, followed by a list of folders, each of which may have more programs. For example, if you click Accessories, a list of programs in the folder appears. You can click on any program to open it. To get back to program list, click the back option near the bottom of the menu. The search box at the bottom of the left pane allows you to search for programs and files on your computer. Right pane of the start menu. The right pane provides access to commonly used folders, files, settings, and features. This is also the place from where you can turn off your computer by clicking the shutdown button. Desktop background and screen saver. The background image that you see on the desktop is called a wallpaper. The image that you see when your computer is idle for a specified time is called a screen saver. Changing wallpaper. You can change the wallpaper as per your choice. To do this, follow the given steps.
Right-click anywhere on the desktop. You will find the list of options. Select the Personalize option. The personalization window will appear. Click the desktop background. A new window with multiple images will appear. Select any background from the displayed list. A preview of the selected background will appear on the monitor. After selecting the background, click the Save Changes button and close the dialog box.
Changing the screen saver. The screen saver is an image which pops up on the computer screen whenever a computer remains idle for a short time. By pressing any key, you can get back to the normal screen again. To change the screen saver, follow the given steps.
Right-click on the blank area of the desktop. Click the Personalize option from the shortcut menu. The personalization window will appear. Click the Screen Saver option. The Screen Saver Settings dialog box will appear. Click the drop-down arrow in Screen Saver section and select Screen Saver of your choice. A mini preview of the Screen Saver will be displayed in the preview box. To watch the preview on full screen, click the preview button. Wait for a few seconds and you will get the preview of the selected screen saver on the full screen. Move the mouse to come back to the screen saver window. Change the time in wait box as per your need. Use up arrow to increase the time and down arrow to decrease. Click the OK button.
Switching off the computer. Once you have finished working, you must switch off the computer carefully. To shut down the computer, follow the given steps.
Click the Start button. The Start menu opens. Click the Shutdown button in the right pane of the Start menu. The messages logging off and then shutting down will appear. In a few seconds, the monitor will turn blank. Now, switch off the power button on the monitor. Switch off the UPS. Switch off the power supply.
Power modes of the computer. The various power modes of the computer are shutdown and sleep. The shutdown mode closes all open programs along with the Windows operating system and then completely turns off the computer. It will not save your work, so you must do so before shutting down the computer. The sleep mode automatically saves all your work in memory and then turns off the computer. In sleep mode, the computer uses very little power. Upon exiting sleep mode, you return to the same screen where you left off. Exiting sleep mode takes very little time. Normal mode and safe mode. Normal mode. In normal mode, Windows load with all files and drivers required for proper functioning of the computer. Safe mode. In safe mode, Windows load with a limited set of files and drivers. If your computer starts in safe mode, it means there is a problem with the computer. It gives you a chance to correct the problem.